Hello everyone, it's Vagrant Story time. Tell me if the game is too loud. This music is incredibly loud, so I'm turning it down a touch. I promise I'll do something about sub badges. Maybe. Question mark. Game's a little loud. This is already with it. The music is amazing, but also I like to be able to hear myself think. Anyway, it turns out that if you let the attract modes run long enough, the emulator can eventually display the entire title screen of the game. That was a fun thing earlier. I only got the middle bottom sixth, which fortunately is the bit with the menu in it. Anyway, please ignore the fact that I went live with the wrong stream information first. And so Stream Elements is only just catching up. Anyway, hey doll, thanks for subbing. Hey Lexi, hey Momo. We're gonna do the thing. There was an attract mode where, this manor has been seized by a guy whose name might have been Sydney? He's a rebel of some sort. He's kidnapped some people. They have a political goal. It's very like the opening of FF Tactics. Sydney, there we go. He is Sydney. I'm not going to try voice acting this because I will run out of posh British accents long before I run out of characters. I think the emulation looks pretty good. I did have a bit of a poke around, but the only concrete advice I found was to use RetroArch, and I don't trust people who say use RetroArch, so... Also, extremely funny to me that the auto-capture had two goes at RetroArch there, and went for rhetoric first, and then restaurant. Anyway, this is us with the antennae. Maybe the reason I like Matsuno games is because everybody's got, bug girl antennae. I'm here for it. Game does look crisp, though. All in due time, my dear. Hey, babe! Hey, Hal! Thanks for coming by. I am going in almost completely blind. I don't know how to play the game. I don't know anything about the story. All I know is that it's a Yasumi Matsuno game. Everybody talks about it being great. And... FF12 was a Yasumi Matsuno game that I love to pieces, so I'm looking forward to this one. I did play a very, very small amount of this before to check that the file was working. Ow. I have to admit, I don't really understand what I'm supposed to be doing. Ow. Or what any component of the interface means. Ow. I hit that whole section without taking any damage before. I love the age where you're supposed to read the manual, because I don't have a manual for this. I'm playing on emulator. Yeah, like, the way the game looks is already stunning. You know, it... People have started to make, like, throwback PS1-style games, finally. Like, Anodyne 2 is a bit like that. There's another one that I haven't bought yet. That's on Steam, and they look like this. Bloodborne PSX as well, yes. Just so good. Yeah, you know, yeah, I think so, Dahl. Like, oh, I have a crossbow. He's got very good claws, Sydney. I'm gonna get fucking owned when this guy grabs that knife. Or not. I feel like that should be causing him more difficulty. Now it's time for me to get owned. Whoa, what the hell? That does look kind of like a fairy tale. It's got a fucking ballista bolt sticking out of its eye. That's so excessive for PS1. Holy shit! I like Ashley's face. That is a face type you do not often see in video games. Was that a fucking vertigo focus pull? In a PS1 game? Fucking what? Holy shit! I'm dead. Dolly zoom, that's... I used to know that term. Ow. I don't understand this information at all. That seems remarkably easy. What's it about to do? Explode? Everything about this is so technologically wild. When did they make this game? It's late PS1, right? Very late PS1. Ah, the fucking building too! 2000, yeah. Fucking birds! Still, every time I get angry about birds in any context, my mind immediately goes to the... Yu-Gi-Oh! The Abridged episode that covers Yugi setting Yami up on a date with Taya. And it turns into the Disney song. The body is but a vessel of the soul, the puppet which bends the soul's tyranny, and though the body is not eternal, for it must feed on the flesh of others, lest it return to the dust whence it came. Therefore must the soul deceive, despise, and murder men. Fascinating. Where am I now? Yeah, that's like the biggest thing I've heard about the game is that the localization is extra good. That looks openable. Oh my god, there's a lot going on here. So that's actually worse. In maybe all particulars? Like, that, the axe seems to make my attack go down by one. My agility go down by one. But give me a bit of, I don't know. What else did I pick up? I didn't pick up a jerkin. Christ alive. I'm definitely going to look up some information on how to play this game. I don't even know why I'm in this basement. I might have accidentally skipped a cutscene. Nope. Oh, I can move the cameras around. Nice. Is there weapon durability in this? Do I need to worry about my weapons getting broken? Is that a door? Looks like there should be some way. I miss something? Ah, right. So don't destroy the crates, they might be the ladder. I'm sure that's not going to lead to me irritating everyone at all in the slightest. I don't think it can be quite that irritating. Ashley really isn't wearing very much. Okay. Chamomile sigil. Okay. A magic floating platform. And we got a character called Guildenstern. How Shakespearean. So something in the attract mode was like, there's a dominant religion, but there's also freedom of religion, or limited freedom of religion. Oh boy. Really? I have no idea what's going on. Right, that's one down. Is the punishment for continually attacking that your risk goes up, and risk going up makes you more likely to be countered? Criticaled? I'll figure out which button does which eventually. I guess I heal up as long as I stand on the circle. But very slowly. I guess that would explain why the character's called a risk breaker. Where's the platform? Oh, there's a bat. And a dog. Fun. Some very scrunkly growls and stuff on the soundtrack at the moment. Why are you here? What the hecky? Didn't like that. Those guys are armored. I feel like... Whoop! Oh, is he... Oh, fuck. That's not a lot of damage. Ow. I feel like something's going to interfere with me. Do I need to get up there? There we go. Got there eventually. Oh, that's not good. What the hell? I keep... I'm gonna die. Yep. Hi, Odai. The dogs are not too big. In fact, the dog was the one thing in this that... okay. I guess we play through that again then. Whoops. Oh, the cutscene's skippable. Next task, figure out how to save. That was the button I was looking for. Right, this is where I think I might have skipped a cutscene. I mean, I couldn't identify the save function. Like, I thought it had to be a save point, but I couldn't see where the save option was. There we go. Okay, so the first thing is go through here. So, X is interact. Ah, okay. Basic controls. Basic controls, page 1 of 22. Oh, I can X to push crates as well. Read me. That's all. Data is where the save is. Right, yes. That's what I was missing. Okay. Let's try this again. We have a first person mode. Let's try to get owned less. Got the first strike for once, nice. Okay. Damn it. Okay, that's one. Do it. Nope. Maybe this one. Okay. Lexi doesn't want to exterminate humans. She needs customers. I might contemplate the extinction of humans. Haven't decided about that one yet. Momo may well get the urges. That's entirely up to her. There, get on the thing. I have a philosophy PhD. I am a creature of endless contemplation. It's a problem. Oops. But I love to contemplate bonking you, Lex. Why are these levels designed like this? I don't entirely know what's going on. Oh, that fucking trap. Right, okay. I can use those to heal. This menu structure is not entirely intuitive. Right. No. What are you doing, bud? Okay, that's that guy then. Put that away. No. Put that away. And jump. There we go. Where is the guy? Down there. Okay. Yeah, I have no idea, like, what the disadvantage to doing things this way is supposed to be. When it stops working, I'll do something else. Ooh, earthquakes. Is that why the base is full of weird ledges? Pre-code? Really? That's the phrasing you're going with, Odai? Door there, or there's a path down below. Poor dog. Okay, that's one. No? Don't boo, Odai. It's a perfectly fine joke. You walked right into it. Is there going to be an encumbrance system in this? Should I be thinking more carefully about what I pick up? No. Is any of this destroyable? Doesn't look like it. And then down here. Oh, they keep getting the jump on me. I see. Right, and I need to put this down there so that, oops. Why the fuck is jump on square? No, put it back, Ashley.
Oh, what horrors awaits me.
No, I keep fucking... I keep putting my weapon away when I want to actually do an attack. Because get weapon out and put weapon away are on different buttons. And attack is on the put weapon away button. And jump is on square. Right, I'm gonna need a crate. Put the weapon away, pick the crate up. No. There we go. Great. Timed platforming. Not just platforming, but timed platforming. Oh, it's Elysium. Hydration check. Oh, it's that boy again. Whose ghost we saw. makers of this game thought that bats were very aggro. No, get down, Ashley. Is that more fucking fireworks outside? Fucking lovely. Not there. Can I stack crates? Yes. Did I stack the crates in the one place? Yep. Of course I did. Fucking goddamn it. Haven't played a game. No, not there. Haven't played a game where the shoulder buttons move the camera in a long time. Open the chest, Ashley. Don't climb on top of it. I don't know why I need my playtime to the 100th of the second. See where this gets us. Another earthquake. Oh, no. Minotaur, maybe? Yep. Ow. Is he going to explode? Huh, okay. Why does the score allow for up to 100 million points? How do I cast spells? Okay. Anything in here? No. Yes. Let's get that stuff. And we got the chamomile sigil. Which presumably means I can open the other door. Uh-oh. Oh, it's that guy. I thought the hand claps were a ticking bomb or something. Most men complacently accept knowledge as truth. They are sheep ruled by fear. But you are different. Almost as if you had no soul. What? Oh, we're back here again. What is he wearing? Shirt's got a lace-up back, like a gacha character's third outfit. Well, they're very dead. That's a better, like, flopping hand on a corpse than most games two generations later can manage. Demonstrably false, Sydney. Who the heck is that? What is happening? So it's a kink thing is what I'm getting from this. Whoa. That doesn't look good. There's a whole lot more going on there than I was expecting, if I'm honest. Also, there's a guy in this room to talk to. Maybe? No? He's just standing. I don't want to attack him. He seems to be harmless. Yeah, I'm just like, I'm always like this in the start of a game where I've not got my bearings yet. Can someone pull this up on how long to beat and let me know what the numbers say there? Oh wow, I thought it was longer than that. Well, we got Tactics Ogre will make up for that. Because I'm sure that one's going to take a while. Where's the doggo? Don't put the friggin' sword away, Ashley. I was a bit surprised to see it's only the one disc. I guess if it's like 20 hours, then that makes more sense. Oh, that fucking trap again. Ugh. I knew I was going to walk back through it on the way back. Let's just... Where are we going? This way. I should just go into every room with my sword out. I don't think the doggo is supposed to go on the lift. Yeah. starting to maybe get the hang of how the movement feels now. There we go. This is the first room. Punch out for it being the game if they could have had the extra room. This would have led space to up. Second playable character. Interesting. Wait, was it? Was it actually this room? Looking for a room that had two exits. One of which had the... Or maybe it is this way. Maybe it's this one. There we go. Oh, he doesn't look like he's in a good way. What the heck? Oh. I think possibly the power of Leomond might be magic, Ashley. This guy hits hard. I don't understand. I'm gonna have to do some reading. I hate reading explainers of RPG systems. They make my brain glaze over. More zombies. Yeah, I am realizing that. Ow! Don't do that. Okay. Okay, how do I use Swordbreak arts? Other things to go looking for a tutorial on. Ouch. Stretch! Posture check. Owie, stop that. This one is a double door. Oh. That's an unpleasantly high-pitched noise. Oh, that's an unpleasantly high-pitched noise. Apologies, headphone users, if that's coming through really loud. That didn't appear to do very much. Oh, I see. You did a lot more than... I didn't actually read the other grimoire that I got, did I? I should do that. The Dullahan might be immune to this, of course. Owie! Ow. Try this again. Put on a part of it that actually takes damage. So I guess break arts cost HP. Whereas magic costs MP. Normal agent. So that's more HP. That's more MP. Ooh, that sounds like fun. Assuming those are permanent. Oh, you have to, that's right, you have to cast the spell. Ah, that's a gemstone. We want to figure out later, I guess, as well. Oh, save point. Can I open this chest? Yes. Oh, I see. It's like a ender chest type deal, I guess. That's a bigger, angrier sort of dog. How? There we go. I didn't even realize the thing here was an enemy at first. Oh, knock it off with the freeze traps. MP seems to recover very quickly. I'm taking this as a sign that I should use it freely. Oh god. What was that? Ah, I see. There's a way out there. And there's even some crates. How handy is that? No. I kind of like how meticulous this is with the crates, of having to, like, put them down every time you want to go up a ledge. No. There we go. Really? Ow. Less of that. You... Really? The other ones went down in two hits. Okay, so what I need to do here, I think... So this is teaching us that there can be half levels. No, put it down, you dingus. There we go.
Bye.
Right, okay, here we go. One 80, 101, 109, 100. Somehow that significantly raises magic defense. Okay. Anything else in here? Doesn't look like it. I'm surprised at how well my emulator's doing with this. I was expecting more trouble. Excuse my yawning, I am sleepy. There's a door there I can't open because it's locked, and a path in this direction. Ooh! That doesn't sound pleasant. Please don't solid shock me. Is that one I didn't learn? I don't like that timer. Oh my god! And I'm silenced. I'm probably going to die! This is really annoying. Yep. Where was my last save? I saved after the armor boss, the Dullahan. But that might have been the last place that I saved. In which case I will... where's this? Thank you. Oh god, this was ages ago. I think what I will do is I will stop there for today and go and learn how to play the game. And we will continue this next week. Thanks for being here, everyone. And may those who oppress you learn shame.